Hello and welcome. This presentation is about the Hebrew letter Yud. This is the Hebrew letter Yud. Okay? And Hebrew letter Yud means hand. Now, Yud is the 10th of 22 Hebrew letters, and it is associated Kabbalistically with the Hermit Tarot card. The Hermit Tarot card. So this is the symbol of the hermit holding his lamp that holds his light, his spiritual wisdom and his spirituality, his light. And usually he holds it under a cloak. And he's very, you know, he doesn't very often expose his light. He's very protective of his light. So this is the association with the Hebrew letter Yud. Okay, now the Hermit card is the ninth major arcana, so its number is 9 on the major arcana in conventional decks. Now, Yud is a diagonal path. The Hebrew letter Yud, is we're talking about this one, Yud. Yud is it's on a diagonal path between the Sephira of Hesed, this blue Sephira of Hesed, and also the yellow Sephira of Tiferet. Tiferet. So that's the yellow one. This is on the queen scale. There's 4 different color scales in Kabbalah. And some of them you're going to have different colors in each of these areas, yeah? Because of the, whether it's a prince or princess scale, with Malkuth being the princess scale. But this is the queen scale. So it has more of a receptive quality about it. And it's about archetypes, that realm. The queen scale is more of a receptive and more about archetypes. Now, so the Sephira of Chesed is associated with mercy, the quality of mercy, Chesed. And it's also associated with the planet Jupiter. And the color on the queen scale is blue. So it's associated with the planet Jupiter, and the Roman god Jupiter, and the Greek god Zeus. Okay? Now, the sixth Sephira here, Hesed is the fourth Sephira. Okay? And the sixth Sephira of Tiferet, means beauty. And that corresponds to the ancient planet of the sun or soul. And see here, it's yellow, like the sun. Now, traditionally, the 22 major arcana in the tarot deck are each associated Kabbalistically and traditionally with a Hebrew letter, one of the Hebrew letters, which in turn corresponds to one of the 12 signs of the zodiac, one of the 7 ancient planets, and one of the 3 elements, with one card and one letter overlapping, both pertaining to the element of earth and one of the planets. So there's one overlap because there's 22. Now, the 22 Hebrew letters, and there's also 22 major arcana in most conventional decks. Yud is the 20th path on the 32 path Kabbalistic tree on the tree of life. So, and there's the tree of life, and then there's the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. That's like the 2 trees in the garden that's shown on the lover's card. We have Adam and Eve, and there's like they symbolize 2 trees. And then you have also on the devil card, we'll have an Adam and an Eve that symbolize 2 trees. Now, we're just going to stick with this right now. This is pretty much the tree of the knowledge of good and evil once you get into it. Because there's angels on this tree, but there's also demons associated with it. So the good tree is considered, that's the one associated with angels. And the klipoth, or the klipot, is a tree that's associated with some entities that disperse things and break things in pieces. Where the klipoth will shatter, this tree will more unite and harmonize. So sort of, one tree is like tikkun olam, to bring together, tikkun, bring things together. Olam means worlds. And then the other tree is like, they break things, and it shatters like shatters the glass, like stomp on the glass and shatter it. Okay, so it's when it's sort of what happened at the beginning of creation, Zimzum, when creator sent the force, the light, through the Sephira and they shattered. So because, and now our job is to collect those pieces and bring them back together. That's Tikkun Olam. All right, that's a, didn't mean to go into all that, but just the picture made me think of it. Okay, so again, 22 Hebrew letters and also 22 major arcana in each tarot deck. And I'm Pastor Rosemary, the astrology angel. I'm a Rosicrucian seer, a biblical astrologer, Christian psychic, and Gnostic mystic. And this is a readings by Rosemary Angelic Transmission. And first, we're going to talk about Virgo the Virgin correspondences. Virgo the Virgin, the sign of Virgo. Again, the sign of Virgo is associated with Yud and also with the Hermit card. Now, the sign of Virgo, the Virgin, is also ruled by the planet Mercury. So the planetary archangel is Raphael. Raphael. Mercury is here and on this tree, on a good tree. And Mercury is here, and on a queen scale, it's orange. The color is orange. And this begins to give you correspondences to do what? That's right, magic. You can use the colors, you can use the numbers. This is the eighth Sephira. And the Sephira is Hod, and this is, again, the planet associated with Mercury. And also the archangel is Raphael. Now, there's some Kabbalistic correspondences that'll tell you that there's that it's different. You know, they'll say that, you know, Gabriel will, the system I follow puts Gabriel in Yesod, which is purple and for the moon, and Raphael in Hod, which is for Mercury. Some traditions will reverse those two, and that's air and water, and that's emotion and intellect. You know, and some traditions will reverse those two, and some say that the Archangel Raphael and the Archangel Gabriel sort of traverse back and forth from path to path, from Sephira to Sephira. But I prefer to put Raphael here. Now, Raphael, the Merkaba field for Raphael looks like this. This is the hexagon that would be for when you're doing hexagrams in a circle. This would be for your celestial coordinates for where you find Aquarius in the heavens. And this is the Merkaba field for air, and for Raphael rules over all of the air signs and also is associated with the planet of Mercury. So this is for Raphael. This is for air. For air. So those are some of the correspondences. Now the zodiac angel for Virgo the Virgin is Hamaliel. Hamaliel for Virgo. Okay, Virgo the Virgin, the zodiac angel Hamaliel. Hamaliel, the birthstone for Virgo, we get something blue at least, that's sapphire. Sapphire is the beautiful gemstone for Virgo. It's a beautiful gemstone, one of my favorites. Now, my recommendation, this author's recommendation, is to use a sapphire rosary, something, some kind of a, you know, bracelet or necklace or rosary, or an amulet with sapphire, and recite Bible verses that we're going to give you here in a moment to protect oneself and one's cared for. Now, as we mentioned, the alchemical metal of Mercury. Now, okay, Mercury is the planet associated with Virgo. It rules over Virgo. It rules over Virgo in the night, and in the day, Mercury rules over Gemini in the day, and Virgo at night. Now, the metal for Mercury is mercury or quicksilver, and the warning here is that quicksilver or mercury is toxic and can cause mercury poisoning. Quicksilver is also a liquid metal at room temperature. And therefore, for these two reasons, quicksilver mercury is neither realistic nor usable for fashioning magical talismans such as rosaries or bracelets or amulets or jewelry or rings. It's not going to be usable for that. So you're going to have to find another metal that's maybe the color of mercury, that's not toxic, and it's something you can work with, and work with that instead. There's a lot of qualities that mercury has. There's a quickness to it, an intelligence to it, and an imaginativeness to it. And you're going to want to, and it's a sort of a messenger ability, you're going to want to find a metal that reminds you of that, that reminds you of those qualities. Something that when you look at the metal, not only is it non-toxic and workable at room temperature, but also it, when you look at it, you think of those qualities. Now also, the Hebrew letter associated with the astrology sign for Virgo, the Virgin, again, it is Yud. Yud for Virgo. And the tarot card? That's right, it's the Hermit. The Hermit and Yud for Virgo. Now the Bible associations, the biblical scriptures that are associated for Virgo corresponding to the Hebrew tribe of Naphtali. The Hebrew tribe of Naphtali is associated with Virgo. And the Hebrew letter Yud and the biblical associations are in Genesis 49:21 for the sign of Virgo because of the tribe of Naphtali. And for the Psalm 119 in the book of Psalms, go to Psalm 119 and you read verses 73 to 80, and that will be listed under the Yud. It'll be the 10th Hebrew letter down. Okay? You'll have Aleph, Beth, and Yud, and Gimel, and Daleth, and Hey. You want to go all the way down to the 10th letter is Yud. And that will encompass verses 73 to 80. And not in all Bibles, but in most Bibles, it'll say Yud. It'll have each Hebrew letter above each sort of group of verses. And in this one, it's verse 73 to 80. And hopefully it'll have Yud written above it. And you can always get a Bible that has Yud or has all the Hebrew letters written above. And those, you can use those for magical workings along with your magical talismans, along with your tarot cards, along with your Hebrew letters, along with your proper angelic statues. And you can also use appropriate colors and the appropriate angels, all from your Kabbalistic correspondences. They're like drawers where you can keep and organize and care for all of your magical entities and beings that all are inside you. They're also in the macrocosm and they're in the microcosm. And you want to work with your own. You want to and fit in properly with the macrocosm. Now, there's also magical correspondences for Mercury, the planet that rules over both Virgo and Gemini. Again, Virgo in the night and Gemini in the day. And the Hebrew letter associated, again, with the planet of Mercury, oh no, we haven't heard this one yet, okay, is Beth. Beth is the Hebrew letter associated with the planet Mercury, which rules over Virgo, okay? Which is associated with Yud. So this is about Yud. This is all the associations that come up with Yud. So Beth. Also Bet. Beth. Bet. A tarot card corresponding to the planet Mercury. Very important. Very important. The Magician. So Bet or Beth. And the Magician card. With the infinity sign above his head. And he's got the stance of as above, so below. He's doing the, you know, the like the Baphomet does or the George Washington statue, as above, so below. And he's got his and as below, so above. And he has his wand and he has his sword or it should be an athame and his cup and his pentacle on his altar, his magical altar, and it stands for wands for fire, and the athame or the knife or the small sword for air, and the cup for water, and for earth, the pentacle. And that's how he does his magic. Again, he's got the infinity sign above his head. He's got a wand in his hand, and he's got one hand projecting, and he's making what is above in the spirit world so below in the physical world, because it happens in the above world first. First it happens spiritually, then it happens physically. And according to Kabbalists, really nothing can occur in the physical realm unless the spiritual realm and the beings in that realm order it to happen. So if your life is out of control, it's because you're not in touch with your angels and all the entities that exist and the forces that exist in these upper worlds. And at one point, you have to get to know the demons as well, because if there's day, there's night. And if you can't live in all light, in Kabbalah, the teaching is you cannot live. This is the pillar of severity, and this is the pillar of mercy. This is the severe pillar is the feminine pillar, and the masculine pillar is the merciful pillar. And what happens is, because things crisscross, like this side of the body is run by this side of the brain and vice versa, because of that, the goddess runs through the body of the god Mars, the soldier. The goddess runs, that current of discipline and severity runs through Mars and logic and practicality. And the god energy runs through Venus, the goddess Venus. That's the emotional and the freedom. And it runs through the feminine body. Okay? Because you cannot live, according to Kabbalah, you cannot live in all darkness and you cannot live in all light. You must live in the nexus between the two. In the nexus between the two. Because too much light, you won't be able to survive, nor will you be able to survive in all darkness. If it was always day, the earth would burn. And if it was always night, the earth would freeze. We would not be able to exist. And that's the most important teaching in Kabbalah. Now, the biblical association for the planet Mercury, corresponding with the Hebrew letter Beth, is Psalm 119, verses 9 to 16. So the biblical association for Mercury, and in the tarot cards, a lot of them will have the Hebrew letter on them. Most of them will have the same Hebrew letter traditionally, but there's some that will switch it a little bit, but don't worry about that. Just stick with traditional decks if you're learning. Biblical association again for Mercury and the magician card corresponding with the letter Beth for Mercury is Psalm 119, and you go to where it says Beth, that's the second letter down, Aleph, Beth, Beth, that's verses 9 to 16. Now, magical talismans for power or protection should be completed 1 or 2 days before any particular astrology event takes effect. Some sorceresses and some sorcerers complete talismans for astrology magic 1 to 2 weeks ahead of time for the purpose of imprinting relevant images upon the subconscious mind of predetermined audiences. How marketing works. Okay. When other astrological factors are taken into account, this could be done months or years in advance of the desired outcome, working through the Kabbalistic world Olam. Remember, Tikkun Olam, to bring worlds together, Olam. The world, the Olam of Atzilut, Bria, Yetzirah, and Asaya. So you bring it from the top worlds of the just an emanation to the archetypal worlds, to the world where you plan, to the world where you take action. So you have the worlds, Olam, Atzilut, emanation, and then you have Bria, the archetype. Then you have, and that's where the angels are, in Bria. They're in the archetypal worlds. in Bria. And in Yetzirah, that's where you have the planning stage, where you make your plans. And then you have Atzilut's on top. I said it wrong. Asaya, excuse me. Did I say that before? Yeah, on the bottom is Asaya, not Atzilut. It's Atzilut, Bria, Yetzirah, and Asaya. Asaya in the bottom here by Malkuth. And Malkuth is in Keter, and Keter is in Malkuth, because you can stack one on top of the other. So, you know, technically there is an Asaya in Atzilut and an Atzilut in Asaya, technically when you stack them on top of each other, but it's Atzilut, Bria, Yetzirah, and Asaya. Asaya is where you have action and the physical world, and then everything below the physical world into the demonic. Okay? All right. Now, the Israeli tribe that we talked about, Naphtali, being associated with Virgo, which is associated with Yud, the Hebrew letter Yud, which is what we're talking about. The correspondences that we're using in this video, the Israeli tribe, Naphtali, being associated with the Hebrew letter Yud and with Virgo, is that the zodiac astrology attributions are based upon common knowledge that was taught through Kabbalistic oral tradition, which I learned, and the teaching cited in this presentation, in this video, and in the document attached in the description box are derived from associations which I was taught in an orally given lecture, which I took notes, popularized by S.L. McGregor Mathers, not from Mathers, but the teacher that was giving the presentation was using Mathers associations. S.L. McGregor Mathers, one of the founders of the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn. Okay? Now, the information that is in this document and that we have attached here, and also in the video presentation that we're giving you, is based completely on the oral tradition known as Kabbalah, which is taught to me by Rosicrucian clergy when I was but a young girl, the facts of which I've committed to memory. Thanks so much for joining us, and join us again soon.